This video will explain the basic concepts of Studio Artist, how to load your own images and videos into the source area, how to change the canvas size, and how to export resolution-independent SVG and EPS files from the Vectorizer. A source image or source video is used in a similar way to how an artist would look at a model. So you can think of the source image in this way. Studio Artist, using artificial intelligence and an embedded model of the human visual cortex, works in a similar way as an artist. By using presets or styles, Studio Artist renders an image into the canvas. You can use our curated presets, or create your own, or have Studio Artist create new presets for you automatically. The source image or source video can be resolution independent of the canvas image. So, for instance, you can have an SD source video which is 1280 by 720, render into a canvas that is set to HD or 4K or even larger for output. Or you could have a source image that is 1000 by 1000 pixels and a canvas size that is 8K or higher. Later in this video, we will talk about strategies using a smaller canvas size while designing and previewing presets. And then how to output your designs on a higher resolution canvas for printing or higher definition video. Let me show you a couple of ways to load your source images or source videos into Studio Artist. An easy way is to just drag an image into the source area. If you choose this method, you will also need to change the canvas aspect ratio to match your source image. You can easily do that through Canvas, Resize Canvas from Source. If you are previewing presets or just designing, you should keep your canvas at 2K or below. So as you can see, my new source image is approximately 6300 by 40K. So I am going to resize my canvas to 2K, while still maintaining the aspect ratio of the original source image. Make sure preserve aspect ratio is checked. Since this canvas is a little larger than what I can see, I am just going to close this help window. You will need to adjust your canvas size according to your own screen. For instance, you may need to use 1.5K or maybe smaller instead of 2K. For the best results, just try to fit the canvas to your screen, without needing to zoom in or out. I do want to note that you can print and output Studio Artist at high resolutions, but while you are previewing presets or designing, you should keep your canvas size below 2K. In a minute, I'll show you how you can use Studio Artist's intelligent rescaling to render out at high resolutions. Another way to load your own source images is to choose File, New Source and Canvas. This will give you the opportunity to match your canvas aspect ratio to your new source image, and also change the canvas to 2K or below. I'm going to change the canvas to be a bit smaller this time so I can bring back the help window. Next, I want to explain the paint action sequence to you. A paint action sequence is a script that combines all the different types of presets from the different image processing modes in Studio Artist, like the paint synthesizer and the vectorizer. I'll just run this first one by choosing it and then clicking action. Studio Artist comes with hundreds of paint action sequence presets which are completely editable. You can use a paint action sequence to record your own design steps while using a smaller canvas. This way you can try things out much faster. Then, when you are ready to render in a higher resolution, just change the canvas size and rerun your paint action sequence preset or one of our factory presets. When you resize the canvas, you will see there's a checkbox here to also rescale the paint action sequence. So you need to check this when you want to print or output a video at a higher resolution than 2K. This will rescale the brush sizes in the paint synthesizer as well as settings in image operations. Next, just render out the image by running the paint action sequence and then save your image. If you are rendering video, at this point you would choose action, process with a paint action sequence and then source to movie and then name your output. When your video is through processing, it will automatically launch the movie player for you to view your processed movie. There are other tutorials specifically for video, animation and rotoscoping, as well as high resolution printing, that you can check out. The last thing I want to touch upon is vector output. First, I'm just going to switch to the vectorizer mode. The vectorizer turns raster images and video into stylized vector art. Studio Artist has natural media vector styles that are computationally complex. So it's much better to have lower resolution canvases when designing or previewing presets. Also, since the vectorizer is resolution independent, you will not need to re-render in a larger canvas for high resolution like we just did. Once you design your look, you can save your vector images as SVG by choosing Action, Generate SVG with Vectorizer. Then you can bring your SVG image into other programs or back into Studio Artist at whatever resolution canvas you want. We recommend using SVG instead of EPS, because SVG handles the complexity of the vectorizer and vector paints much better than EPS. You can also generate SVG with a paint action sequence. But if there are raster steps in the paint action sequence, they will not output to SVG or EPS. This is a little more advanced, and there are other videos that go into more detail regarding this. Have fun using your own images with Studio Artist. Please do not hesitate to contact us with questions through our support tab on the synthetic.com website. The next video will introduce you to three of the image processing modes in Studio Artist: the Paint Synthesizer, which is the intelligent paint engine in Studio Artist, the Vectorizer, which we just briefly visited, and Image Operations, which are similar to Photoshop plugins.